What is up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel for Horror Talk. On today's Horror Talk, we are going to be talking about a series that's had a few problems along the way. Let's get to it. First of all, what is up, everybody? I am Zombie Chris. I'm your host for Horror Talk. If you're new here, Horror Talk is where we simply talk horror. You can check me out on Twitter and Instagram at ZombieCT. Back in 1987, there was a movie that came out that pretty much no one expected was going to be this cultural phenomenon in the sci-fi horror world. And I'm talking about Predator, which came out in 1987. It was in the summertime, shot on a budget of $15 million. It grossed over $59 million at the box office. It also made Arnold Schwarzenegger like a top tier action guy to go to for movies, especially for, the early 90s. It also spawned a few Rocky films after that. So it came out with Predators 2 in 1990. Yeah, it's not a good movie. It's not a good sequel, let alone it's an okay movie. I think it's grown on me. If it's on TV, I'll sit and watch it, but it's not anything that I would recommend that people watch. And then we have the Requiem, and we have the Aliens vs. Predator series, which is kind of like a spinoff. Most people don't usually count those as part of the Predator series, even though it's starring the Predator. Those movies were just plain bad. I've only seen them like once. Maybe one day I'll go back and rewatch them, give them another chance, but not anytime soon. And we also have Predators, which was the last time we've actually had a Predator movie. That was back in 2010, starring Andrew Brody, which is kind of shocking to see him in that kind of movie after he's kind of known for doing these drama, heavy Oscar winning kind of roles. So I really enjoyed that movie. I liked it. I didn't have too much of a problem with that movie. But now we fast forward and it is 2014. 20th Century Fox makes an announcement that there is a new Predator movie coming. It's going to be directed and written by Shane Black. If you do not know Shane Black, he is responsible for a lot of cool movies here and there. I'll give him credit for some stuff. So he wrote such movies as The Monster Squad, Lethal Weapon, and its sequel, The Last Boy Scout, Last Action Hero, which I loved that movie to death. Also starring Arnold Schwarzenegger as well. Also The Long Kiss Goodnight. He was also an actor in Predator, if you did not know, so that's kind of cool to have an actor who was in the original movie return back to direct a movie. He also directed Iron Man 3, if you know that, Edge, The Nice Guys, which is a pretty funny movie, and now The Predator, which is coming out in 2018. It's coming out in September 14, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. The teaser trailer just dropped. Not a lot of people knew too much about this project. Like I said, back in 2014, it was announced. It just finished wrapping up filming in 2017. And now we're getting the trailer and it's due out in September. So that could sort of be a bad omen when movies take that long. They kind of sit on the shelf. There's problems with the behind the scene productions, there's problem with the writing. So who knows? I'm just ready to watch the teaser trailer, see what it's gonna look like. Then we're gonna come back and talk about that and as well as my love for the Predator series. So let's get to it.
Thank you. gave up the mission. Did you see anything unusual?
Like an alien, you mean?
He saw something.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And you meant someone or something tore them to pieces.
I think they're attempting hybridization. They're upgrading on every planet they visit.
We need to know if you pose a threat.
We're assassins. Isn't posing a threat kind of the point?
So, the Predator trailer. Yeah, I'm not quite sure that's what I was expecting from a Predator trailer. I'm kind of at a loss for words on this trailer. It definitely reminded me of like Predators or last Alien movie to come out. It reminded me sort of like those trailers where it's quick, it's flashy, it's bam, bam, bam. There's not too much on the story. But then again, it's a Predator movie. There doesn't really need to be too much on the story. We know, like, the Predator comes and he hunts, and that's pretty much the premise. Like, the first one was a mystery, and it was a monster movie, and it was sci-fi because we didn't know what this creature was, but it was sort of like just tribal and like one man versus beast in a war setting. And then the sequel tried to take the Predators to the city. This one seems like they're returning back to the city. They're saying that the Predators have upgraded themselves with DNA from other species. Not quite sure if that means we're gonna see different Predators or just one. I see that it is starring a couple different people that's well known. It's got Jake Busey in there. It's got Thomas Jane. Olivia Munn, I'm not the biggest fan of hers. We also have Sterling K. Brown, who's from American Crime series, and This Is Us, which is a popular NBC drama show. So he could play it pretty seriously in this role, but this movie kind of just requires a little bit of everything. It requires a little bit of B-movie kind of acting, a little bit of jokiness, and a little bit of seriousness just to kind of push the story along a little bit. I didn't gather much from the trailer as far as the story or any of these characters I should care about. It just seemed like Predators come to Earth and they're killing, and that's pretty much what we're giving you. At least Predators kind of took a different approach with the movie and the way the premise was on that, and it was in the future, and it kind of gave you the feeling of the first movie but set in a modern tale. So I enjoyed that a little bit more than what I got from this trailer. That really shocked me. I thought I was gonna go bonkers for this trailer. It looks okay. It just doesn't look amazing, but it looks okay for a Predator movie. Also, there was a rumor that Arnold Schwarzenegger might make an appearance somewhere in this movie. I'm sure there's going to be Easter eggs dating back to the first movie, as well as maybe the second movie, because this, if you do not know, The Predator takes place between the sequel and between Predators, which is set in the future. So it's somewhere between that timeline. It's just, you know, modern day, like right now, type of time frame. Yeah, I don't know what else I can say on that. I love the Predator series. Every time the first movie is on TV, I'm always like sitting there watching it. I love all the quotes that we've gotten from Arnold Schwarzenegger in that movie. The creature design on the Predator itself, it's spectacular. It's amazing, especially if you ever see somebody in the full costume, like in person, at a con or a festival. It's crazy to see how they look. Yeah, Predators are back. What do you think? Leave it down in the comment section. Are you a big Predator fan? What did you think of the trailer? As well, follow me on ZombieCT over on Twitter and Instagram, and I will catch you guys on the next Horror Talk. Goodbye. Good afternoon when you're watching this. Good morning whenever. Zombie Chris is out of here.